Hello and welcome back to Dutch Modeling, today with another inbox review. For this inbox review I really have to give a big thank you to Stevens International for providing the review sample I have in front of me, which is the new KV-220 Russian Tiger super heavy tank. It's a Trumpeter, as you know I like Trumpeter, so I'm doing this. And in that said I have to thank the people over at KitMaker Network for sending it to me. Another one in the Trumpeter KV series, so actually don't even have to review because I probably know all the parts ready and it will be a good fake, good kit. Also I have to give a sarcastic thank you to the postal services around the world for absolutely squashing the box. It was well packed, but I'm guessing they shipped an elephant with it and put it on top of the box. But shit happens. So, box art, it's the KV. You can see it has an extra rope wheel that will be longer than the normal KV. Here on the side, we got a little write up. And again, like I said, thanks to Stevens International. And there's the write up for the ones you want to read. So, metal edge parts and a metal barrel, which is also nice. The kit number there. 05553. The side is again the box art. Here's again painting options, which is green and more box art. Well, the green isn't a surprise, on the back there's nothing. So let's open it. I saw the damage, so I did do a little look in the box before when I got it, and the only thing that I saw was damaged was the photo of the, let's see what a big thing this is the decal sheet, sorry. So I will open this first just to check for damage. Get everything out of the box. This looked, everything looks fine still, so we'll see what happens when we get through the box. So now let's just start with the instructions as always. Here's here this Trumpeter's little overview, what they're gonna do. It will be a J7A fighter. This KV-220. A new Soviet IS or JS-2, which looks very interesting. A missile boat, stealthy from China. And the big 1/16 Yak Tiger. So this is upcoming for September, November 2016, so they will be all released probably. Back. Now we got color callouts, and it actually just needs steel and green. Have fun. I'm guessing it's a prototype tank. You can do whatever you want. It got lost in battle, so you even can blow it up or whatever you want to do with it. If everything goes according to plan, you probably would see somewhere in that corner or in that corner a speed up video, small inlet video where you see me building it and pointing out any mistakes they're made or fit issues. Probably it will be a short vid. I do not expect a lot of fit issues with the KV's line of Trumpeter because they made so many. Here we got the sprue map. Nice and numbered as always. Start with making the sprocket wheel. The rope wheels make 14 of them. Two idler wheels. The bump stops go on the bottom lower hole. Rear light goes on. Towing eyes go on. And this is the mud scraper that goes on. And both sides, of course. Towing eyes go on, and the suspension arms go on. Then the wheels go on. Sorry, that came out of nothing. Sorry for that. Wheels go on. The spacer for the sprocket wheel goes on. And the spacer for the idler wheel goes on, sorry. And the token eyes on the front guard. Damn. I know I'm allergic to dogs, but now even that they start barking or starting to sneezing, that's bad. The idler goes on, return rollers go on, sprocket wheel goes on. And the part I always wondered what it is. I have to check what it is exactly. And I've got a link from a very friendly person who I can just not remember my name now. Anything on the KV or the IS series of tanks is a site called 4BO Green, I believe. I will augment it in the comment section, but that's everything you ever want to know about KVs or ISs, and I probably even think T-44s. So, you know that. There's a difference between return rollers. Make 6, make 2. What's the difference? This is different. Why is it different? B1 to 12. Oh, well, probably. Start on the upper hole. The vision ports go in for the driver. The plate on the front, light, horn, the hatches, open or closed. You got to choose whatever you want. Exhaust, pipes go on. Air vents go in with photo edge, standing up nice and big. Headlight, bow machine gun, cover, the hatch, front opening hatch, okay. And then the upper hole goes on to the lower hole. Track assembly. As far as I've seen, the unlike. And then the upper hole goes on to the lower hole. Track assembly. As far as I've seen, unlike the other KVs, you do not have the choice between the link and length and the rubber band this time. They just did the link and length, and that's probably a wise choice, but I'm not sure, so don't crucify me. I do not think anybody used the rubber bands anymore. So, a little bit of armor and the mudguards. Extra armor part here, and then the holders for the mudguards go in. Toolboxes go on, tow cables go on, towing eyes go on. Yeah, that's it. Oh, yes, use cyanide, cyoacrylate superglue. Sorry, start of the turret. The back hatch, reinforced with extra thick armor plating, viewports go in, bottom of the turret goes in. Is it only one viewport? Why, that thing was blind. Sorry, but they couldn't see anything. Only viewport. Gun mantlet, multiple parts. There's no turret interior whatsoever. Two. Because this is for vision as well. Hatches go in. No, only one hatch goes in, sorry. The hand railings go on. The mat that goes on with the, I'm guessing this is supposed to be the coaxial gun, machine gun. This is the, will be the commander's hatch. In the building up. There's a slight difference, apparently. Let me check if I can see it. M3 or C18. But it probably will be metal then. Yeah, I'm guessing it's M3 and M is mostly metal. Pointed out to be metal. Oh, no. I see the difference. Sorry. This is rounded. And this is hexagonal. Another nice English word. So, if you go for the round or the bulky one. Now I can see the difference. Yep. And that's the only way. Everything that goes in or on top is almost the same. So covers for the viewports, so there are two. And then the option between the metal barrel, the body slide molded barrel. So go metal or go plastic. That's your choice. And then at the end, of course, it's done. So, not the most complicated build. So let's start with, like I said, I want to see the decals, because according to the decal options, there are none, so that's good. And it is damaged. You can see in the plastic, hopefully, or maybe, the dents there. See, the dents, it actually is all thanks to the postal service. I don't know what they did with this, but let's see how bad this damage is. You got the numbers 0 to 9 both two times, of all both two times. The Russian flag twice and the Russian star twice, and those dimples managed to miss everything. So that's a good thing. See if you can. There. Just next to the 9. I don't know how well the camera will pick this up. But these are the decals you get with it. According to the options. The painting options you just saw, there are no decals on it, so this is always nice, you can do whatever you want. And now we're going with the specials as well, so we're going to open this one. Nice sturdy brass wire, that's always nice. Can see, and some photo edge, which is luckily not a lot, just some grills and some parts for the glacis plate, as we saw in the instructions. I'll put it in there later because it won't fit now. Let's start with the hole. This is a new thing, that's for sure. Also the metal barrel, I'm going to open that as well because I want to see if it's there's a groove on the inside. No. Oh, this is a shame. It is hollowed out, but maybe half a centimeter. I don't know if how well you can see this. You see, it is somewhat hollowed out, but nowhere near far enough. That's a shame, actually. It's very lightweight. It's aluminum. Looks good. The metal barrel is always a good thing, so don't complain too much. So the KV-220, it's big. Damn, it's big. Yeah, let's do a size comparison. I got a KV-1 built up completely, so with everything on. So let's see. Let's take this off and put it on the bum. This should be. Yeah. Just put it next to each other like this. So you can see. Quite a lot bigger with the top on it. Just for size comparison. It will widen out because the fenders go on and the wheels and everything, so you would need to see it like this. So yeah, it's gonna be a bit bigger. It's a bit dusty. Oh well. So that for size comparison. That detail. Rivets, bolt heads. There's a welding seam, which looks very good. A little bit of cleanup there. A lot of bolts on the other side. Hatches on the other side. Yeah. Nice detail overall. Let's see. The welding texture. Welding seems very nice. All the extra detail on the bottom. And then on the sides. You actually see the bolt heads and everything. Nothing on the inside, but then again, there's no detail on the inside of the turret as well, so it looks good. It's quite a big hunk of plastic, so that's a good thing. Now, I'm gonna pick some. I forgot to take out earlier, and I need it in a minute. Sorry for that. The upper hole. And I cleaned out the extra sprue gauge here. That's nice. Thank you. That's work for us. This seems so flimsy. Well, it's not warped. Normally KV parts are warped, so the detail, there isn't a lot of detail on this. The weld seams is nice again. Not the base of the turret as well. Bolted are good, the hinges here look fine, and a lot of bolt heads. So you can see this is the most detail you get there, and then the welding seams around there, as you can see all around. So that looks nice. Yep. Back. Next up to the tracks. Take them all. They got two sets. Let's see. I'm going to take out only these because of heat shirt over it. No ejector pin marks. That's a good thing. That's the most important thing. There is some cleanup, of course, because you got the sprue gauge, but that's everything there on the side, and they're pretty small, so that's going to be easy. And like I said, now you get the pin marks, so that's a good thing. That's okay, just going to look at this. These are the preformed, so you got always got the slack in it. That's always a good thing, I think, I believe. It's my opinion, you see. It's waving. Again, no ejector, some flash, just a little bit here. I'll show you that in a second. This is new, so, because these will be too big for the KV-1, won't they? Yeah, definitely too big for the KV-1, so these are new. These are new molds, and already some flash, that's a shame. It's only a little bit, but still. And only one spot, and exactly the same spot. This one got the same too. Oh, sorry. Let me check. Yeah, same spot, so I'm guessing. I'm guessing there's a the molds are a little bit damaged or didn't seal right, because it has exactly the same spot and exactly the same amount. So I just think I just didn't seal right. Otherwise they look very good. Detail wise it's very nice. See, and it's quite a length. inside. So I see, as you can see, no ejector pin marks. So that's good. That's good. Moving on, wheels. Like I said, I looked through the box to see if there's no further damage except for the box, and turned out to be a little bit on the photo edge. Now we'll be getting in familiar territory because these are Trumpeter's 2005 KV-1 sprues. So if you see my channel, you've seen these wheels before. Nothing special, nothing new, you say. They also start to be a little bit flashy, some holes like here. Not quite open. Some flash on the sides. Let's say the sprues are starting to show their age. Some here. It's I'll show it to you. So these are the same sprues you saw on my lightest, for example the KV-8. That's the same wheels as this one. It's also a pretty new kit, but the build-up KV-1 I just used for comparison, that's the original kit. It has these as well, and that's a 2005 kit. So it's, yeah, well, I can say it's 17 years old now. This is new. With one of the, I'll take it out as well. This is one of the two cupolas. Don't know what the other one is, probably someone else. This is the hexagonal, that thing, the bulky one. There's a little bit of cleanup on the sides. I don't know if this is a sprue gate or if you needed to. No, that will be cut off, I guess. Detail, some bolts. Some bolts on the front. Like I said, some flashing. This is the food box. This is a new kit. You see there? This just needs some cleanup. It's a shame, really. I'm free, as you can see. Not a lot of detail for otherwise. That's it. And here's the big turret. Very pronounced. You can hear it. That's the weld seam. That's very thick. Again, cleanup required. Yes, I'm moaning about the cleanup, I know, but still, it's a new kit, and I know they can do better than this. Very smooth, so you will need to be adding texture to this, because it's as smooth as a baby's skin, so to speak. Weld seams are very pronounced. You could hear it just a moment. You clean up here. I just already took it off here on the inside. There, as you can see, there. And the weld seams on the side. That looks good. The details are good. But it's just, I don't know, I expected more, to be honest. That looks gorgeous, it seems. And that's not the problem. Mama turret and baby turret back in. We've got an extrude with delicate parts. We'll just bind them together. That's a new one. I normally didn't do this. the handrails, these are new parts, KV-220, third handrails, the big ones, small one, these are for the mud guards, the big air suckers at the back, and some hatches with some opening detail, because you can display them open, of course. So this will be covered up with photo edge, so you won't be able to see in. Some ejector pretty much there, so they're pretty smartly placed. These getting off, these two will be not funny. Let's speak like that, because they're pretty thin. We need to cut them at four places. So that will be a challenge to get them out in one piece. But that's the trouble you got with every maker who has finished stuff like that, you see. Detail there. The hatches. Show you the hatches on the inside. You can display them open. You got two of the same sprues. Don't need to see the other one. It's back in. Next sprue. Going back to KV-1 era. Take one. Toolboxes. Oh, it's KV-220, so this is new. This is new. It still looks the same. The machine gun. I really hope this is supposed to be there. Otherwise, this is a injector pin marker. Really not smartly placed. But I would have to check that. Yeah, the other one has the same, so I'll show up in a close-up in a minute. Suspension arms, return rollers, vision blocks, bump stops, cover, towing eyes, very small wheel by the looks of it here. Some sort of cover, no clue what. With four ejector pin marks on the back. I'm curious what that it's for. The exhausts here. So this looks all clean. A little bit of dirty. That doesn't matter really. Oh, here's a lot. Here's some big parts of flesh here. Around the toolboxes. You can see the return rollers there, towing eyes, vision ports, some bump stops, the arms, spring arms, more vision blocks that cover. There's the plate, there's the toolboxes, you can see here clearly where the flash is. Exhaust ports. There's the machine gun. Detail on that thing looks very nice. I just want to beneath that middle. Where's my finger? There's that bump. There in the middle. I wonder if it's supposed to be there because it's not both sides. And the other side's even more pronounced. Just there. I wonder if that thing's supposed to be there. So it will be a search online to see if that little dimple needs to be there. The other one, sprue is at least on the toolbox, is cleaner. So. Oh well. I can hear people now saying you shouldn't. What's the saying? Don't look a gifted horse in the mouth or something like that. Well,
yes, you do.
Needs to be good, no matter what. This is the old KV sprue. There's some flash around these sprocket wheel here. Inside. Yeah, this one is really showing his age. Sorry to say, flash there, there. Yeah. Here's a big part. Oh no, that's supposed to be there, sorry. That's my mistake. Exhausts. I need cleaning. A lot. This sprue really is showing his age. The welding detail on the back plate is fading. Pump stops there. The idler wheel. Oh, two parts here broke off. Those two broke off and they're not in the back. Maybe they're in the box, but no, they're not in the box because I emptied the box already, so that shit. That's not good. Not good at all. Well, that's probably has nothing to do with, well, it's kind of why only those two. This is strange. But of course I saw extras in these, but I will need them because I got extra wheels. Gonna check the box again just to make sure. Maybe they're underneath here. Nope, no extra plastic. So that's a shame. They're not in the back. So we have to see how that we're gonna do with this. Probably some styrene rod or something like that and fix it. But like I said, this sprue is showing his age. A lot of flash here in the pump stops. But then again, you got these small parts here, and they're clean. Now that's very strange. Well, let me show you. You can make up your own mind. See there, all the dirty it is. Here. Here, you can see the two broke off. You can see the stretch marks. Put it on like this. So they just snapped. I'm gonna see online if I can see more reviews if they actually snapped or that this is a malfunction in the process of molding it. As you can see, there's they all need a lot of cleanup. You can see here and there and there. Up here. See around the edge, all jagged. Gonna turn this around. Yep. I'm gonna see what's left of the. That's a supposed to be welding seam. Like there. It's faded. There's flash there. So, yeah. Like I said, for those two pieces, I have to check if I can find other reviews to see if those are missing as well. Because if they are, it's a production fault. Which is kind of strange that if they're both, and they're not even the highest point. And in the back where they sit, here's some damage from this big one, and here's some damage from these two. But there's nothing here. And there's some damage here for this and for that. But the back here seems undamaged. So I wonder if they're snapped off during production. So, last sprue. This will be a new sprue. With the rounded baby cupola, turret front, mantlet, mud guards, turret bottom, the extra armature from the front, towing eyes, or tow cable eyes. Still don't know why they do not hollow those out so you can insert the cable. If the seat you can drill them out. Very big seam line there. Vision ports. Bow machine gun. Where's the barrel? There's the barrel. There and there. Slide mobile barrel. Opened. Yeah. Rivet detail is very nice. Some injected pin mark on the inside, of course, but otherwise, well, just a little bit muddy, you won't see it. Headlight, no clear parts. There are no clear parts. Normally, you get the headlight in a clear part, but not with this kit, though. No welding detail on the gun mantlet. There's a little bit of a casting texture on the gun mantlet. It's the only casting texture I've seen on the whole kit. Nothing on the turret, nothing on the bar, on the hull, upper or lower. It's the first part, and it looks good. It actually looks very good. It will stand out as a sore thumb, but still, it looks good. Hooks for the towing cable. Yep. I would go with the more buffier, smaller commander's turret, to be honest. It took a long time to show you because I was kind of gathering my thoughts about what to say. And I'm guessing for the first time, I'm very sorry about this, but I'm going to stay honest, I'm not happy about this kit. Let's see if you can see the casting detail a little bit better on the sides there. I don't know if the camera can pick it up because I can't really see the screen. See if we can wiggle it a bit with some sunlight get on there. And that's that. That's the last sprue. Well, what do we think? It's a tough one, to be honest. As you know by now, I'm a huge fan of Trumpeter. And I'm kind of sorry to say, but I'm not happy with this kit. It's gonna be a good build. I'm almost certain of that. And it's just because they've done so many of the KVs. Would expect that they know how to fit it, and I don't think the finish will be an issue. It's just the overall quality. I mean, you got some testing texture on this part and on the other side, and that's it. This is smooth. This is all smooth. It got one big hunk of steel where the welding seam lies above instead of in, as it should be. And you hear it because I could just move over it with my fingers, it's that pronounced. But then the sides of this huge turret slab of steel is just smooth as a baby's skin, and the Russian steel wasn't smooth. I mean, it's rough. That's what I know, what you know about. So there's no smoothness in that steel. That's one of the things. Otherwise, it's just too clean everything for the looks. The overall sprues, they're just not good. The fit will be good, I don't doubt that 1 second, but the amount of flash you saw, especially on the older, the original KV sprues, and I probably still have, I will still have fun building this, because I like the subjects. The KV series is one of my favorite series, so that won't be the problem. It's just, I very much get the feeling with this is kind of Trumpeter's way of going dragon, so to speak. I mean, look at the Dragon Panzer 4. What is it? The Ace Pro with the wheels. That's 10, 15 years old, and it shows his age. And Trumpeter is doing the same with the KV sprues. You saw the wheels, everything. The detail gets soft. There's a lot and a lot of flash on everything, almost. It's just a shame. It doesn't have to be. They're going the dragon way, and that's not a good thing. So, I'm thinking this is going to be seen as a money pit. That's put in all the old sprues, put in one or two new sprues, and it's okay. It's not okay. Sorry, I can't be much more positive than that. Normally, KVs, the Trumpeters are. Yay! This one is more like, yay, or nay. We'll see how it builds up. If everything works out as planned, you should be to see the build up unpainted version at the end of this video, because that's something new I'm gonna try. And yeah, so hope the fitting was everything, and you'll see what it is. So goodbye. So, the beast is done. The KV-220 from Trumpeter's newest release. And to be completely honest, I'm not very impressed. Trumpeter very much, and especially the KV series. But this thing has some faults, especially for a new kit. I'm not very happy about. I go to the model about first. There are some little things in the instructions I'd like to go over with you first. There are just only a couple, but still, if you decide to build it. Yeah. The road wheels go together very hard. You really have to push them in. And that's not an easy task. I'll show you in a minute. I'll take one off. There you go. The fit is so damn tight, and I'm just wanting to place for sure, press them together, just touched it with the Tamiya extra fin, and it just burst open. That's that tight, and also on the back of the turret, but sorry for that. So that's not a good fit. There are some parts on the upper structure there from the new sprues, they're not a good fit, but I'll show you that in a minute. this is something. You can see it starts out here. It's one of the entry hatches. You see there's a little hole there. And there's still a little hole there. And then all of a sudden, there's this thingy here. There. And there it is again. That's a dragon maneuver. Gonna see if I can get it up close. Probably widening out. See. Oh, sorry. You got it there. There's the hole, as you can see. And the next step, there's still a hole. And when you turn the page, all of a sudden, where is it? I have to watch. This is pretty. There, you got that ring. It just appears while looking over the sprues. That's supposed to be sprue B1, number 10. Just a little, if you can add it there. It just appears out of nowhere. The rest is all pretty good. And then here's a little thing. C23 must be C22, but that's also okay. It's doable, and that's actually that. Those are the only two mistakes I found in the instructions, so that's okay. The kit itself, though, yeah, you got the metal barrel, but that's you can't push it further in, and it's hardly holding on, so that's not a very good fit. Now let's keep with the turret first. So you got this. Well, let's need some super glue and it will stick, but it doesn't really hold on to this. Now you got this miniature turret with the machine gun. I use some white tack in there to keep the machine gun in place. It's either that or glue it in place, because otherwise it will just keep falling out. They might have thought about that better. Then there's the fit, and I don't know if you, oh no, it's, no it goes, but if you see underneath, the gaps, and there's only one way this fit in, because it's not symmetrical. And these, I know this is the underside, but still, the gaps in the sides there, it's pretty big. The same here with the underside, and this is a new turret, this is, if you see all along here, how much space there still is, you can fill. You have to fill it. Oh well, you don't have to, but on this side as well. It just doesn't fit very well. Now you got this back plate. This exists out of two parts. As you can see here. Take this. Here, B180, and then C22. The number 18 goes in here, and this slots over it. This thing fits, again, so badly, so tightly, that I thought, well, just dab it with a little glue and make sure it won't go anywhere. And, well, I kind of repaired it. Well, let's see if it went to... See, just here in this corner, it just burst open. Because there's so much stress on the plastic, the second you push it in, you either have to send it back all around, which, well, I'm guessing it's not supposed to be, because it's a new kit and it should fit. But then again, it's so damn tight, if you, the second you even touch it, it didn't have a chance to react. It was actually with, say, this is the glue, just that, and it burst. That shouldn't be happening. And then of course there's the texture, or rather the lack of it. And I'm guessing everybody knows that, especially in World War II, the Russians didn't really care about the finesse of a nicely looking tank. It was all rough and just not very gracefully looking, let's say. There's no texture whatsoever on the entire tank except here. The mantle cheeks. If they would have done this texture all over the turret, would be good. But now you kind of have to go in with your Mr. Servicer and make texture on the side, because even the German armor wasn't this smooth, and especially the Russian armor. And this is a prototype tank; they really didn't want to go all smoothing it out. It would be rough as hell. And the only texture in this is here. Well, yeah. Make of that what you want. Then there's, you know, like I said, the bad fit. It just doesn't want to stay in. You really have to glue this in. That's it. That's also not the best I've ever done. And oh yeah, you can hear that, how you have to force it in. And then, like I said, the machine gun, you have to glue it to the roof of the mini turret, or with white tech, otherwise it would just keep falling inside the big turret. You have to get it off all the time. The main hole. Tracks, nothing wrong with those. Let's see if I can get a wheel out. I don't know if the camera will pick this up. It's the same with the thing on the back of the turret. See? That's how tight the fit is. It just cracks in the middle. That's awesome. And these wheels are from sprues from 2001. I built another KV-1 and they went together perfectly. So I don't know if they have changed anything to those wheels, but something isn't right, that's for sure. But that was kind of shame. Shouldn't be happening. Then you got... This is just a little tip. You got two parts of PE. And you see here, I kind of screwed up. Because they don't really show you where to put it. And they only say this, install this first. And, well, yeah, I screwed up first. If you do this first, do this part next to it, second. And this is final. I started with these, and just to guesstimate it where they needed to be. And as you can see here, I have to get this off and move this a bit there because it has to touch it. So it's that first, that second, that first. It's just a little tip. Another drawback on this kit is there are no clear parts. So the headlight, you can see, it's just gray. It's a shame. Not really a deal breaker, but yeah. Otherwise than that is the, this is the tow cable. Well, that's good, there's nothing wrong with that. But, give me a second, I should have prepared this but I forgot, because I just remembered. What are they? These are, I'm gonna cut one off so I can show you better. I'm cleaning it up, I'm not just cutting it off. These are the tow cable eyes. Well, you see the thickness of the tow. You kind of have to drill that open to get the tow cable in or glue it on. But as you can see, the tow cable itself. See the thickness is next to each other. I hope it will pick it up. Is almost as thick, so it's almost impossible to drill this open. And if you glue it on, you will break it even by looking at it. Because the link between all those little pieces of metal, because it isn't a solid surface, and this will be so damn real, just blowing a little bit wind will break it off. That's the reason why I didn't put it on yet. I have to see, find out a way to get this in here. So this will be a 0.2 mil, 0.3 mil drill bit. I have to drill this open, much bigger, and it just won't work. So, and now these come here, of course, or on this side, just what you want. And so that's also a thing. It would be nice. I don't know how much it's possible. It would be nice to have it drilled open. Plus. This part around here is supposed to represent the same cable you got, they deliver with the kit. And again, there's no texture on that cable whatsoever. So you should, again, you don't have to, but it looks much better if you actually kind of get that metal texture all around the towing eye. And you got four of these, so that's some work. For the rest of the fit, except for the parts on the turret and the wheels, the fit was pretty good. It was good, like a normal Trumpeter kit. So, I can see that you got the got tracks done, all the wheels. You got the built-in sack, which is also a good thing. Again, I just loosened them so I can always take them off again, as you can see. They're very easy to assemble. You actually got some leftovers, some spare tracks, for in case you screw one up or so. So that's no problem. This all fits together. You can always take it off again. And there's a little bit of photo edge with it. No, like I said, again, like especially for the headlight, just a little bit of a clear part would have been nice. And the complete. Almost complete absence of any texture. It's a shame. It could have been so much better. It would have. It seems it would be. Yeah. They could have done much better with this one, to be honest. The majority of the good kit is good. It's a Trumpeter KV-1. There isn't a lot they can screw up. But kind of the things they screwed up, they could screw up, they did. It's, again, the texture, yes, I'm whining about the texture, but it's just a thing with the Russian tanks. They are not, they're not smooth. They are rough. And like I said, it's a shit big ass turret, so why not do it? Especially if you do it in front here. You do it here, you get texture, and here you get smooth. It's just, yeah. And then the fit issues on the back, on the wheels, this little turret here, this being so loose. It's just all the things they've come, could have done better, to be honest. So, if you don't mind doing a little bit extra work, it isn't a bad kit. But do not think of it as another good KV series tank from Trumpeter, because it's not as good as the other ones they've brought out in the KV series so far. I built a KV-1, I still have a KV-8 to do, and I've done a review on that one. That looks better than this one, to be honest. So you can do nice things with this one, that's for sure. But it's definitely not up there with the rest of the competitors, Trumpeter KVs. So do with it what you like. I hope you enjoyed this new series, new style review. Again, I'd like to thank Aram Rama and Stevens International for providing the kit. And I hope to see you next time. Bye-bye.